This is Rebecca from chemistryismyjam.com. In this video, we're going to be discussing scientific observations and types of variables. Let's get started with observations. There are two major types of scientific observation that you can make. The first one is a quantitative observation. Quantitative observations are measurable. They have a number and a unit associated with them. For example, you might say, I used 32 milliliters of fluid, or the room is 24 degrees Celsius. There are 10 cars in the parking lot. Each one of these observations has both a number and a unit associated with it. The other type of observation is a qualitative observation. Qualitative observations are more subjective and do not have numbers associated with them. So you might say, the room is cold. There are a lot of cars in the parking lot. In science, we prefer quantitative observations, and that's because we want science experiments to be repeatable. And in order for something to be repeatable, it's best to know the exact numbers that go along with your measurements. So whenever possible, we want to make quantitative observations. The observations that we make during an experiment are often related to the changes that are taking place. So let's define those changes. The first one is called the independent variable. And the independent variable is the one that is intentionally changed by the scientist. This is sometimes called the manipulated variable. This is the item that the scientist is trying to study. Now, other things will react to that change. And so we call those the dependent variables. Dependent variables respond to changes in the independent variable. Dependent variables are often called responding variables. Let's look at an example. In the picture, the scientist is changing the pH of the solution. That is the independent variable. That is the thing that she is intentionally changing. Colors changed because of the change in the pH. Those colors responded to the change in the pH. Those are the dependent variables. So the independent variable is intentionally changed, and the dependent variable responds to the independent variable. Here is an acronym that may help you keep all of this straight. It's dry mix. The D is for dependent variable, which is often called the responding variable, and this is very often found on the y-axis if you're graphing the data from your experiment. The M is for manipulated variable, which is another name for the independent variable, which is often found on the x-axis during your experiment. Another type of variable that you should be aware of is a controlled variable. Controlled variables remain the same throughout the experiment. The purpose of controlled variables is to make sure that your experiment is measuring what you intend for it to measure. It's making sure that other things don't sneak in and affect your data. Ideally, in a controlled experiment, all of the variables will be controlled, meaning they'll stay the same, except for the independent and dependent variables. That way, the only thing that changes your data are the things that you are actually studying. Let's look at a scenario where we're going to identify the dependent variable, the independent variable, and any controlled variables that are present. Here's the scenario. You are trying to determine which of three substances has the higher heat of solution. You add the same amount of each substance to the same amount of water at the same initial temperature. You measure the final temperature. So what is it that you're trying to study? You're trying to determine which of the three substances has the higher heat of solution. So the thing that is being intentionally changed by the scientist, the independent variable, the three substances. What responds to that? What is our dependent variable in this case? Our dependent variable is what we're going to measure. That's the final temperature. And then finally, what were some things that we kept the same throughout the experiment? What are our controlled variables? Our controlled variables are the same amount of each substance, the same amount of water, and the same initial temperature. All of those things were kept the same so that when we measured our final temperature, we know that the differences that we saw were only due to the substance that we started with. It was a controlled experiment. So that wraps up our discussion of the scientific method. Stick around as we continue Unit 1 by discussing the metric system.